If you're considering going into marketing, there's a few things that you probably want to know. Today I'm going to go over a couple of those key concepts and what you can expect. We're going to talk about what marketing is like, what marketers actually do, and the different kind of roles you can find yourself in within a marketing department. So instead of starting with what marketers actually do, I want to tell you what marketing is like. A lot of marketing is hurry up and wait. There's a lot of designing, creating, approvals, then you get rejected, and then you start all over again. Designing, create, approve, get rejected. It's an endless cycle. When it comes to marketing, a lot of the work that you are going to do isn't gonna pay off for at least 4 to 5 months. And that's a lot, that's hard for people to hear sometimes because you're not gonna get a lot of instant gratification when it comes to marketing simply because results don't come that fast in this type of job. Sometimes you'll get all the way through designing and you're about to implement this awesome ad idea and then you'll get a message from the CEO that he doesn't like it. He doesn't like the wording. And that's the only explanation you'll get. That happens all the time, so be prepared for that. If you don't like rejection, then this is not, and I repeat that this is not the type of job that you wanna do. You don't wanna do sales, you don't wanna do marketing. You get rejected a ton. And a lot of the rejection is what you think is just the best idea in the world. They just come crashing down. So just be prepared for that. So if you made it this far and you're still interested in marketing, and trust me, you should because despite what I've said previously, it's an incredibly rewarding career. If you've made it this far and you want to know what marketers actually do, let me tell you. Okay, so first things first, let's start with the actual definition of marketing. According to the American Marketing Association, marketing is the activity, set of institutions, processes for creating, communicating, delivering, and exchanging offerings that have value for customers, clients, partners, and society at large. Personally, I think that's kind of a convoluted definition and it makes it sound like it's more complicated than it is, like someone who's trying to make their job seem important wrote it. I think that a better definition of marketing is the creation and delivery of compelling and engaging content that drives decision making. That's essentially what marketing is. That means that your role within the marketing department is going to fall under one of three categories. Design, create, and deliver. Sometimes, and this happens a lot, the marketing department is only gonna be you. And sometimes it'll be you and one other person. Sometimes you'll have a full team. It really kind of depends on where you happen to get your foot in the door if you're just starting out. A lot of times, the first place you start, it will be you and only you. And you will be responsible for all three aspects. So even if you have a preference in doing one above the other, you should know every single one so you have an idea of what to do and where people are coming from if you end up being the only person in the marketing department. Let's break down all three of these strategies into a little bit more detail. So first we have design. This is where all marketing campaigns start from. Design is the strategy. This refers to the overarching strategy that you're gonna use for all of your campaigns going forward. Design phase aims to answer four basic questions. Person, place, time, and message. Before you start anything else, you need to answer those four questions. Who are you trying to advertise to you? Where are the ads gonna be most effective? What time are they gonna be most effective? And what messaging is gonna be most effective? Again, going back to the definition of marketing, the whole purpose of marketing is for your ads to influence behavior. That's what you're trying to do. So it doesn't matter what the behavior is. It doesn't matter if the behavior is someone signing a petition, or if the behavior is someone buying a laptop. At the end of the day, your job as a marketer is to influence behavior. Before you can influence behavior, you need to know who you are trying to influence. A lot of people don't do this step. A lot of people just gloss right over and just start writing ads and start designing graphics and start implementing Facebook ads without actually knowing who their exact target market is. Person, place, time, and message. You can't go any farther until you answer those four. Once you have your campaigns designed, now it's time to create. The creative phase is what a lot of people think of when they think of marketing. If we're talking in madman terms, this is Don Draper. This was the side of the agency that he controlled. Now, little known fact, the creative phase is not actually how most marketing agencies make their money. The way marketing agencies make their money is they buy ads from the media companies such as television or Facebook or Google, and then they resell them to the companies that they're doing the marketing for at a higher price. The creative part is just the cherry on top. Now with that being said, this is usually the most enjoyable part of the process. This is where you really get to Let your creative side out. This is all of the graphic design, the video production, the audio production, all of the fun parts, quote unquote, of marketing. This is where they live, in the creative side. So now that we've done the design in the creative phase, it's time for the third aspect, which is the delivery. And let me tell you right now, before you go any farther, this is the single most in-demand part of a marketing agency right now. Especially with the rise of digital media, the delivery portion of a marketing agency is an incredibly sought after and high paying position. If you're looking to get into marketing, I would implore you to figure out how to run Facebook ads, how to run Google ads, how to talk to influencers, how to run LinkedIn and Twitter, Pinterest. Understand especially all of the social media, because that is the current biggest opening door into any marketing agency. The delivery campaign is essentially taking all of the creative parts that you've made and pushing them to the right customers. What you want to be able to do is be able to segment all of your customers and show them the right content at the right time, at the right place, with the right message, just like we talked about before. And the delivery is the final aspect of that. So what does a typical marketing team look like, and what are the potential roles you could find yourself in? The first basic position you have is a strategist. This is the person that's going to design the overarching strategy for the campaigns. This is typically a marketing manager or a director, and they are usually not only responsible for designing it, but also judging the performance and reporting on that performance to the higher ups, usually the board of directors, or the CEO, the CMO, things like that. Now, underneath the director, you'll have a couple of positions. A lot of times you'll have a copywriter, a graphic designer, you have a specialist in terms of social media, and then you also usually have a media buying position. Graphic designer, copywriter, those are pretty self-explanatory. Those are the people that write the actual ad content and create the actual ads. In some agencies and in some companies, you also have people who specialize in video production and audio production if they're big into radio and television, or if they're doing YouTube ads, which they should be doing because it's a completely undersaturated market. But that's a story for another video. A media buyer is just a name for someone who handles the contracts between usually TV and radio stations and your company. They're responsible for placing the orders, making sure things run on time, making sure that the TV and radio stations have all the content that they need. The digital specialist is someone who runs all of the Facebook, Google, digital ads, and they also usually handle things like SEO and other aspects of the website and things like that. With that being said, I worked in multiple jobs where I am the only one. I'm responsible for the strategy, for the implementation, for all the media buying, for all the follow-up, for everything. And then, like I said, if you're trying to get your foot in the door and build a resume, there's a great chance that you're going to end up being the only one in the marketing department. A lot of times, unfortunately, a marketing is kind of a secondhand expense. It's the first thing to get cut when the budget gets tight, and it's the last thing to get funding when there's extra budget. So just be aware of that. A lot of what you're going to be doing is going to be incredibly creative and managing and moving money around as much as you can to have the highest ROI possible. Very few jobs are out there where they just will give you an unlimited amount of money to throw at your customers. You can always outspend your competitors, but you can't always outthink your competitors. If you can be good at marketing without having a massive budget behind you, you will find a job anywhere. It's always about the ROAS, the return on ad spend. That's the only number that you need to worry about. If you have a high return on ad spend, you will find a job anywhere. I want to finish this video by saying that marketing is an incredibly rewarding career. There are few other jobs that you can do that require so much effort and so much time and so much patience that you don't actually see the reward for 3 or 4 months. But when you do, there's nothing more satisfying. Sure, you can build a cabinet, and then when you're done with the cabinet, it's done, it looks good. But the amount of time that goes to building a really, really good marketing campaign. A marketing campaign so good that someone searches for it just to watch it again. That's the peak of good marketing. I hope you consider going into marketing. It's an incredible career. You make incredible connections. It's so much fun. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, please comment them down below. I'll either answer them there or try to make another video. Thank you so much. Thanks, Marco. You good? You good? Hey, look! Good boy. Thumbs up for Marco.